Welcome to the Royal Tyrrell Museum's prepared collection storage area. This is where fossils are stored for research and safekeeping when they're not on display. Now, some of the fossils here are unique, including our holotypes. A holotype is the single specimen used to formally describe and name a new species. Sometimes it's the first one found, but not always, and often it's not the most complete fossil. Behind this locked door is a room devoted exclusively to our type specimens. Some of the fossils in here are literally one of a kind because we don't have any other examples of those species. What holotypes does the museum have in its collections? By the 1980s, when the museum opened, many of the well-known dinosaurs already had their names. However, there are many fossils in our museum that were collected before the museum was built. One example is the type specimen of the dromaeosaur Saurnithelestes langstoni. Fossil hunter Irene Vanderlo, who was responsible for finding several important specimens, discovered this dromaeosaur in Dinosaur Provincial Park in 1974. She came across small bones that ended up belonging to a new species. Around 20 years later, another amateur fossil hunter discovered another new dromaeosaur, this one right near the museum. In 1995, Wayne Marshall came across what would later be known as a Trociraptor marshalli. To date, these bones represent the only examples we have of this species. You may notice this room is pretty small, and some of our dinosaur holotypes are huge and also way too cool to not put on display in the museum. If you go into the museum galleries, you can see some of our holotypes, including Regaliceratops Peter Hughesi, Borealopelta Mark Mitchelli, and Coronasaurus Brinkmani. In some cases, a holotype can be a single bone. Take, for example, Boreonychus certicorum. When describing this species, scientists used a few other specimens to fully describe it, but this single bone is the holotype. There's also Albertofenator currii, represented by this bone here. In fact, both of these holotypes are frontal bones, which in dinosaurs is the bone right above the eye. Most dinosaurs don't fossilize completely. The bones that do become fossils tend to be harder or more common parts of the body. Take, for example, our dome-headed pachycephalosaurs. Many species are known just from their skull cap alone, like Acrotholus adeti here. Some other dinosaur holotypes in our collection include Apatoraptor pinnatus, Unescoceratops coppelhusei, and Pachyrhinosaurus lacustei. What about animals other than dinosaurs? Well, here in the galleries, we have the bones of the largest flying reptile ever discovered in Canada, Cryodracon boreas, the coal dragon of the north winds. The type specimen of this species includes these bones, all of which are part of an associated partial skeleton. We have quite a few aquatic animal holotypes, a couple of which are named after our former curator of marine reptiles, the late Dr. Betsy Nichols. There's Nichollsora borealis, a plesiosaur found during mining operations by Syncrude, and Nichollsemys baieri, a sea turtle skull discovered by David Baier, who is also honored by the species name. You can see both of these type fossils in the museum galleries. Back in our type room, we have several aquatic animal fossils found by museum staff. There are sharks like Homolodontus aplopagus, ichthyosaurs like Parvenitator wapitiensis, and alligators like Stangerochampsa mccabei. There are mammals here too, but much of our mammal material is quite small, like this jaw of Didelphodon coyi. Observant museum visitors might spot a model of this small mammal hanging from the trees in our Cretaceous Alberta exhibit. Now, holotypes aren't just from body fossils. They can be from trace fossils as well. This is a Quadrilovipes suibaldae, footprints of an ancient bird. And here is Montanoolithus strongorum, a clutch of five eggs thought to be from a dromaeosaur. As you can see, the Royal Tyrrell Museum has some amazing holotype specimens in its collections. And you probably noticed a lot of the ones were found by amateur fossil hunters. Who knows? Maybe you'll find a holotype the next time you're out exploring in the Badlands. And the door is locked still. It is locked. Anyone have keys? Anyone? No? Got keys. No. It's one of these ones here. This one, right? Yeah, okay. I can't. Tom, can you? And cut to... Ah, ta-da!